Hello and welcome to another edition of Compass, the sectoral chart book from DSP Mutual Fund. My name is Charanjit Singh. I'll be talking about the consumer durables and electrical sector, broad trends in the sector, and also explain our view on the sector. Consumer durables sector has a market cap of rupees 3 lakh crores and revenue of rupees 65,000 crores for FY21. Consumer electricals and appliances sector got the consumer tag as companies moved away from their industrial roots and evolved into more consumer-centric business models. We have seen focus shifting towards more innovative and feature-rich products. This slide shows consumer durable electrical products and their market sizes. The overall market size of the three distinct end markets, which are consumer electricals, small appliances and white goods, is currently at around 2 lakh crores and growing at a pace of 10 to 12% per annum, with some of the mature categories like fans growing at slower pace, while room AC is growing at a faster pace due to lower penetration. We believe there is a significant room for this sector to expand over the next decade, driven by 1. Electrification of rural households, rising disposable income, rising home upgradation market for the last 4 to 5 years, mainly across rural and semi-urban markets, easy availability of finance at low lending rates, specifically applicable to consumer durables market, and government's focus on providing affordable housing and overall infrastructure creation. COVID has also led to increased growth for the home upgradation segment due to work from home being the new normal for the foreseeable future. We are seeing Indian brands are aiming to scale up their businesses by focusing on adjacencies, expanding their distribution channels. This is how the consumer durables and electricals products market is positioned in the Indian context. Residential real estate market is one of the key drivers for the consumer durables and electrical sector, and the revival of this sector has been long overdue. During FY 2011, we saw value of adjusted construction output reporting a CAGR of 16%, then growth rate tapering to around 8% CAGR during FY 12 to 20. As per prop equity residential real estate data, 2011 had seen the peak launches to sales, followed by muted activity for last 10 years. In CY10, as COVID restrictions eased, demand bounced back sharply and growth metrics were exceeding the previous quarters of earlier years. Inventory levels have started reducing post-2020 and launches are rising to meet increased demand. With banks offering lowest ever home loan rates and the economy gradually recovering, we believe the residential real estate market is ripe for multi-year growth revival. This will drive the demand for both consumer electrical and durable products. Central government CAPEX is another key driver for demand of consumer electrical products. Central government CAPEX has seen a significant push as it has risen to 2.9% of GDP, the highest since FY08, which used to hover on an average at around 1.7%. Despite COVID, government has sustained on an average 2.5% of GDP as spending on infrastructure from FY21 to 23, which clearly indicates the focus to revive the economy through infra creation. We expect government-funded programs to drive immediate demand for the cables sector. Some of the initiatives include improving power T&D infrastructure, adding renewable energy capacities, 100% railways electrification by December 23, expansion of the metro network, and higher spending on roads and highways. The government is also increasing its focus on electric vehicles, which augurs well for the wires and cables industry. Overall, strong economic recovery would aid demand growth for cables from both commercial establishments and public utilities. On this slide, the first chart on the top shows how the deficits are coming down for power sector. The residential sector consumes nearly a quarter of total electricity in India. Key components of consumption are lighting, refrigerators, room air conditioners, and other electrical equipment. The Government of India's Power for All and 24/7 power programs are major step in the direction to provide quality power to consumers. Government's aim is to provide access to electricity round the clock to each household. The energy deficit has reduced to 0.7% in FY20 from 4.2% in FY14, which is clearly indicating the positive impact of these initiatives. The second chart on this slide shows how organized segment is expected to grow faster versus the unorganized segment. Unorganized segment formed average 30% of key segments in this market. However, end user requirements for better quality products, brand awareness, creation by larger brands, financing and supply chain issues being faced by the unorganized players is forcing the shift in the favor of organized players. We expect the unorganized segment to decline, thereby delivering higher growth for organized players. We believe the larger players will continue to grab market share from unorganized players led by huge capacities, efficient supply chains, and wide distribution networks along with strong balance sheets. This slide indicates two important trends of penetration and premiumization in the consumer durables segment. What makes these end markets more exciting is the low penetration of several products in the white goods space and technology-driven replacement cycles for some of the product categories. The first chart on the left-hand side indicates the penetration in each of the product categories in the Indian market versus the other Asian geographies, and the large gap between these two geographies clearly indicate a long runway for growth. For the electrical vendors, apart from tapping the recurring demand, we see the focus is also increasing on upgrading of the products, which provides a room for premiumization of some of the categories. With strong replacement demand and improving consumer lifestyles, the demand for differentiated premium products is growing faster than the overall market. This slide indicates how the revenues for both consumer durables and consumer electricals listed companies have scaled up from FY08 to 21. Consumer durables listed space has seen revenue scaling up from 3,500 crores in FY08 to 14,600 crores in FY20 with a CAGR of 11%. The lower chart indicates consumer electricals companies, which also includes wires and cables companies, revenue scaling up from 8,500 crores in FY08 to 35,000 crores in FY20 and growing at a CAGR of 12% over the time frame. Valuations of BSE Consumer Durables Index have risen sharply post-COVID based on the expectation of pent-up demand for consumer products and pickup in momentum in the industrial or infrastructure CAPEX. In the near term, sector faces certain headwinds such as inflation worries on passing the price hikes, which are becoming tougher, demand getting impacted for entry-level products. The valuations have corrected marginally but continue to trade above plus one standard deviation. We believe weakness in demand and margin compression of the underlying companies could correct the valuations further, thereby making the sector attractive from long-term investment perspective. This sector offers strong growth visibility, pricing power, and healthy balance sheets. That's the summary of our views on the sector. If you have any comments, suggestions, or questions, please drop them in the comment section and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.